5G NR circuit designers are facing the challenges of designing high-performance wideband and sometimes millimeter wave ICs that need to operate with complex modulation. Simulating performance metrics such as EVM and ACPR prior to tape-out has always been a challenge in most circuit design software. But what if you could make these measurements quickly and easily and use that data during the design process rather than as a final circuit validation step? This example schematic and these results should represent exactly what you are looking for. This simulation took a matter of minutes to run, and it gives swept power results for EVM and ACPR, as well as spectrum and waveform results. It was created using our circuit design tool, PathWave ADS 2021, and a feature known as virtual test benches, or VTBs. They use the power of our PathWave system design software to create and analyze modulated waveforms inside the ADS environment. I'd like to show you just how easy it is to set up and run this type of simulation on an existing circuit design. This schematic shows a representative power amplifier similar to the ones you design. I can add a 5G NR VTB from the component palette here. Once this is added to the schematic, it's quite simple to set the required parameters for simulation. Here I've already configured the frequency and input power. The envelope simulation controller is created from this tab of the VTB. Running this simulation takes about 10 minutes, so I've already saved the results data to show you. You can see the main measurement of interest for spectrum, EVM, and ACLR are all plotted versus the input power sweep. There are many other settings and parameters that can be varied in the simulation, so let's go back to the schematic and highlight those in more detail. The main RF simulation settings are first in the VTB. We have set the input and output frequencies to a variable to make sweeping frequency easy as well. You can also see our input power from our current sweep. The remaining several settings allow you to modify some of the parameters of the modulator that is creating the signal. This could represent the real input to your power amplifier, such as an upconversion mixer. Now we really get into the 5G NR modulation parameters. Bandwidth can be set to all possible values for the 5G NR specification. Numerology, or subcarrier spacing, can also be adjusted over all the required test values for the UE uplink specified by 3GPP. This source supports both FR1 and FR2 frequency ranges, as well as both CPOFDM and DFTS-OFDM. Modulations up to 256 QAM can be configured, and you can easily set the resource block allocations using the common configurations as specified in 3GPP Technical Specification 38.521. If you need to make any modifications outside of these configurations, you can choose a user-defined mode and set the resource block configurations yourself. Once you've configured these parameters, choose the Envelope Controller tab and press the Insert Envelope Controller on Schematic to add the simulation controller with the correct frequency configuration for this simulation. Next, let's look at the envelope controller itself. The VTB actually controls the simulation time and step, so this is not needed from the designer. It also configures the carrier frequency to match the VTB settings. I'll draw your attention to the section Enable Fast Envelope. When this is turned on, ADS will create a proprietary behavioral model called a Fast Circuit Envelope, or FCE model, of the PA for envelope simulation. This offers circuit-level accuracy while greatly speeding up your simulation. In this example, I ran using our Level 3 envelope model, which accounts for in-band memory effects. Level 1 is a memoryless model and the fastest simulation, while Level 5 includes both in-band and out-of-band effects, such as those from your BIOS network. By leaving the box unchecked, you'll run a circuit envelope simulation on the full transistor level circuit. Using this approach, it is very easy to test the accuracy of the behavioral models and make trade-offs of simulation speed versus measurement accuracy. The FCE model has the added benefit of being a portable model. After simulation, the model can be instantiated in our PathWave system design software for even more detailed system-level simulations. This provides a great way to connect your system and circuit design teams.